Hey, it's Fran. Again at the bench. Deja vu. Yeah, I'm making this video as the follow-up to the last video about the Lumitime repair and teardown. And, well, even though I'm posting this video right after that last video, in real time, it's actually been about 6 days that this clock has been running on my bench. And I've been running it at the full brightness, so full AC, none of that half-wave stuff, to see if the lamps would repair. And there has been some pretty dramatic change. The lamps on the far side here, the star lamp, there's one lamp in there for the star, and a few of these in the minute segments, for the minute indicator. Some of those lamps were really flickering really, really bad when I first cleaned out the contact wheels. And after 5 days of running full AC, a lot of them have seemed to repair themselves. The little electrodes have sloughed off the impurities running on pure AC. And this one in particular was flickering pretty badly. I think both of these were, but several of them in the minute indicator were pretty bad. But as this has run, the ones on this side of the display, the ones that are cycling a lot, the minutes turn on and off a lot more, every minute it changes, as opposed to the hours side, which now is really the only where the problems is a couple in the hour indicator that are flickering, not at 3 o'clock, unfortunately, because it's actually the one over here, these two on the far end, which don't turn on as much. So there's definitely seems to be, at least anecdotally, a correlation between the flicker problem and the degree to which the segments are actually on. So the segments that don't turn on that much and don't switch over that often. Oh, there we go. There's one there. You can see two here. The one on that one there is flickering, and that one there is flickering. But yeah, so if I switch to the half wave, bringing the diode in, you can see that only one pole is lit. On AC, they're both lit. And you notice that when I turn off the AC and go to DC half wave, the flickering stops, right? But also, notice how dim that lamp is. Oh, that one's flickering there at half wave. But then when I go up to full AC, see that flickering stopped. So, yeah. So there's a correlation between the fact that this clock probably was running on the dim setting for a long, long, long time, and manifestation of, what they refer to as cathode death in these sort of cold cathode displays. When it's running AC, there is no cathode, no anode, because the current is constantly jumping from one pole to the other and back and back and forth. But when you introduce the diode and cut the brightness in half and it's going half wave, then one of those electrodes does become a cathode and the other becomes an anode. So people are going to watch this. They're going to say, "Fran, I mean, why don't you just replace these lamps? It's obvious they're old. Just replace the lamps. Problem solved. It's going to be repaired. That would be the right thing to do." And I would say, no, not quite, not by a long shot, because the last thing you'd ever want to do is take a Lumitime clock like this and replace the lamps, these vintage 70s era long life neon lamps, with modern Chinese made neon lamps. You would be very sorry if you did that, because as far as I know, there's no company that makes long life neon lamps anymore. I mean, the ones you get from Chinese manufacturers, those lamps, they might run 1,000 hours, which you might think, well, that's a long time, Fran. Well, no, it's not, because in a clock like this, something that's going to run all the time, if you replaced all the lamps in this clock, if you spent the time to do that, you'd find that after a month, 2 months, 3 months, lamps would begin to fail. and you'd start, they'd just start off shutting off and flickering badly and then just failing. Because these modern-made lamps, they're short life. These lamps, these ones that are in the Lumitime clocks, these are extremely long life. They're hundreds of thousands of hours rated, which is why these clocks can have, you know, 10, 15 years of use on them, and, you know, 40 years later, they're still running, and all the lamps are still on, you know. So I'm really trying to find out if the flicker issue can be reversed just by running it at the full current, full AC. It does seem to have some validity, because these on the right side have stopped flickering. So it's probably just a matter of time. The hour side, these change over, you know, only on every hour as opposed to every minute. So, you know, I think maybe in a few months, I think maybe the lamps on this side would have cycled enough to maybe get, you know, rectified. I would not be surprised if these original lamps are thorated. I wouldn't be surprised at all if the electrodes are thorated, because one of the issues with cold cathode neon displays is the initialization of ionization. There has to be some energy, a little bit of energy, to start the plasma, to strike the plasma, to get it going. Because there's no heat, there's no heated cathode, there's no heating element in there, there's nothing to provide any energy. So in order for a display like this to be reliable, there has to be some little bit of energy to initiate the ionization. So I would not be surprised if with lamps this small that they would use a thorated, you know, a little bit of thorium in the metals, in the electrodes, to provide a tiny little bit of emission just to start the ionization, you know. And the Nixie tubes, they used krypton 85 in the Jan stuff as to initiate ionization, and something, a bigger gas-filled tube like a Nixie tube, that makes sense. But in something like a neon lamp, like something this small, it doesn't make sense to put, you know, an irradiated gas in there, because you just wouldn't have enough of it for it to really be reliable. So it would make sense if they had a thorated element in there. But anyway, I'm going to put this back together. So yeah, so let's put it back in the case. I'm going to wait for the second dot to get up to the 12 o'clock position before I shut it off. That way I can resynchronize the clock when I turn it on again. All right. So I thoroughly washed the diffuser. It was pretty dirty. I actually had to just get it under the sink and wash it with soap and water, although it's still got some residue on it, but I don't think it's going to cover any of the segments. But that's going to help with the look a lot, I think. And I've already oiled all the mechanism and everything, and it's been running for days, so the oil's, you know, I put a drop on the cog, the main drive cog, and then basically as the clock runs, it just kind of runs the oil around the whole gear train, just gets transferred around and around. And I cleaned the wheels several times, so probably did it too much. And the bezel's all clean, so good. One thing I really couldn't do is the little dot for the second dot that goes around. I just couldn't. I mean, I got it as it's clean. It's just it's dim, just because it's actually a light pipe rather than just being an opening in the, you know, in the screen here. It doesn't use a reflector. It's actually a light pipe going to the back, and it just, whatever, it's molded, but for whatever reason, that light pipe is just not efficient. It just doesn't gather enough light on the bottom side, and it's not from being dirty. I've cleaned the inside too, but it was just a bad idea. I don't know why they went with a light pipe when just a reflector would have probably been a lot brighter. But all right, you gotta be very careful with these little self-tappers. teeny tiny self-tappers. I find it's very handy, especially when you're trying to feel the thread, not to use the top of the screwdriver, but just put your finger on the shaft, and you can feel the thread. It's really for a delicate touch. And you don't want to torque down on the screws at all. Just make contact. Probably should, if I have a screw that I could put in there, because there's no screw in that. It's a tapped. That motor has actually deformed. It's all plastic, so the motor casing and the motor mounts, it's all plastic, and over time that it has bent. I can see the base there. It's just, so yeah, it can't really be fixed. It's just bent back. Nothing to do about that. Alright, so. There's a tiny little hole down there for the alarm. Alright. Vacuumed out the inside of the case as much as I could. Just. There we go. Earth. Knob a little indicator on it. Okay. Okay. Oof. So people were asking me in the comments of the first video what this little door was for, and the answer to that is if you look at the Tamura clocks, the ones made for the Japanese market would come with two different idler gears that you could swap out on the motor, because in Japan they have two different standards. There's a 50 hertz and a 60 hertz in different parts of Japan. It's a remnant of peculiar origins of electricity in Japan. They bought generators from America and from Germany in different parts of the country. Still have the split standard today. So, yeah, for the models to be sold in Japan. It's interesting. Somebody had been tried to open this up. You see that screw there, it's the head stripped out. So somebody was, had this thing open at some point. Maybe someone tried to do a repair at some point. It was kind of aggressive with the screw. Oh. Yeah. Looks like the nut fell out of that. I gotta open this up again. It's felt like the insert came out when I pushed on it, so yeah. Yep. So now, oh jeez. Ugh. I gotta take the knobs off again. Alright. Good thing I didn't push down too hard on those. I did not think that the inserts would pop out. Yep. Yeah, there it is. Floating around in there. Hello. Where did that pop out of? Oh, I see. It's right here. Right. Let's see, there's four of them in there, but that one's just a little loose. I'm gonna put a little Always keep a bottle of cheap nail polish on the bench. Works good as a cheap glue. Little dot corner there. Whew. Good old nitrocellulose nail polish. So, yeah, I just put a dot in there, kind of like using it like Gliptol. And I want to, while it's still wet, I'm going to put the screws in. It can dry out because the clock is ventilated, so it'll ventilate the fumes. I'm not going to put the knobs on. Now I'm going to put the knobs back on. There. All right. Now, pop back on. There we go. It's not, you know, after you get the whole thing together, it's not bright at all. We were looking at it without any of the coverings, but with the tinted front and everything, it's pretty dim. I mean, the only reason you would need that, or even want, to turn on that that dim function would be if it was a bedside clock. But it's certainly dim enough at full brightness. So yeah, I'm going to run this in the office where I can look at it every day. And yep, I'd consider it fixed, and hopefully as I put more hours on it, it'll continue to to reduce the flicker on these far left lamps. But all right. But there you go. Prepared, and we learned some new stuff about Lumitime clocks, and particularly that the lamps, you can, if they start to flicker, you can bring them back. I wonder if the same technique works with other kinds of neon lamps, typically in like power strips and stuff, especially the ones I buy recently. They have little neon lamps in there, and they tend to fail within the first year. You know, they start getting flickery and then they just stop working. I wonder if reducing the limiting resistor in those things, running a much higher current, running full AC, if you can reverse some of that flickering, or, you know, or not. Maybe it only works on the older long life lamps, but who knows. But in this case, it definitely seemed to reverse course on the flicker, so I'm very happy about that. All right. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks, too, to all my patrons down on Patreon. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We did a recent push for new Patreon members, and I thank everybody who came on board to be new patrons. Thank you, thank you. So if you like what I do, consider becoming a patron. It's really the only reason we're able to do all this crazy stuff. Just follow the link in the description. I will thank you personally. All right. I'm Fran. I'll be back here, maybe at the bench, maybe at the drafting table, maybe over at the factory. Gonna be back over there soon, so you never know where I'm gonna be, but I'm definitely gonna be doing something. Bye! That's where I work. In the lab. Go!
berserk. In my lab, it's where I work.
Still flickering. Ah. It'll get better.